Hey y'all, welcome back to Cooking with Munchies. My name is Christine, and today we are cooking. What are we cooking, Jada?
We're cooking apple pie.
Yay! We are cooking apple pie, and this recipe is so good that you guys are going to love it. And if you do not want to make your own crust, go ahead and go to the store and buy a prepaid packaged crust. So first, we're going to wash off our apples, take that little barcode off the apple, put it in a pan or a bowl, because this is what I got, a pan, not a bowl. Then we're going to add some baking soda to it, some vinegar, and some water. And we're going to let it sit for 5 minutes. A lot of people say, why do I do this? It's because when you buy your apples and fruits and all that stuff from the produce area, the fruits and stuff area, it has a lot of pesticides, a lot of things that you don't need in your body. Even though we're not going to use the skin, we're still going to clean it, okay? We got to clean it. So we're going to let it clean for about 5 minutes. Because we don't want that C word. You know what I mean. So it's now nice and clean now. Now we're going to do our dough. I'm using 3 cups of just regular all-purpose flour. Not the self-rising one. Then I'm adding 1 tablespoon of salt. And mix it in. You want to mix it in before you add your butter. Because it's not going to be incorporated really well. Then I have 2 sticks of butter. Yo, I'm just using regular margarine. I'm not using no butter. And I'm getting one cup of cold water from my water filter because I didn't have ice and I didn't feel like waiting for my water to get frozen inside my freezer. Yeah, I'm that person. Then I'm going to mush the butter inside the flour mixture until it's dissolved, and then I'm going to add the water. Once we add that water, we're going to keep mixing and mixing. It's going to get really sticky, very sticky. So if you have a blender, I would recommend using that, but my hands will do. Then we're going to peel the apple off. And you can use a knife or you can use a potato peeler. You can use whatever you want. You can cut them up however you want to. It's still going to be an apple pie. Okay. So I'm just going to cut them up. Just like a regular apple pie. And for this pie, it is a deep dish pie, and I have 6 apples or 5. I have 5 apples, and I didn't even use them all. I only used some of them. And we definitely don't want them dirty little seeds. You can go ahead and plant those and make some more apples. And see, this is how mine is cut. It's not perfect at all, because I'm not a baker. So I'm going to put it in the bowl. This pot was actually too small for it. So I had to end up putting it inside of another pan that I do not like to pull out, because you'll see when you see it. Now I'm going to put a little bit of flour on my struggling cutting board. And I'm going to slice it in half so that way we can have the top and the bottom. So this is the bottom. And the other half is sitting somewhere. And then I'm going to add a little bit of oil. I'm using vegetable oil. You can use whatever oil you want. And I'm just spreading it around the pan so it doesn't stick. And I really, really tried to make this crust perfect. There were so many holes in here. Y'all got to trust the process. You got to really trust it. And I'm punching holes inside of the pie crust so that way it doesn't bubble up and create a whole big old mess. And I'm adding some butter because y'all, you see this crust, it's a little bit dry right there. So we definitely want to brush it with some butter. I did have a brush, but I don't know where it went. My utensils always disappear. So I'm putting it in the oven on 350 for 5 minutes. And then I'm going to add my oh God seasonings, okay, to this. We're adding 3 tablespoons of cinnamon, 1 cup of regular sugar, and 1 cup of brown sugar. I'm also adding 2 tablespoons of vanilla and 1/2 tablespoon of salt. And then mix it in really good. And here's our pie crust 5 minutes later. And then 1 cup of butter. Yes, butter, butter. Oh, Lord. Yes. Apple pie has to have butter. If it doesn't have butter, then you're not eating an apple pie. So once we mix it in and it is mixed in to the color, to the tea, to everything, to where it looks really good, to where you want to just eat it out the pan. Pour it in the pan and add some of those juices to it. You don't want to over add it, over juice it, because it will soak through that pie crust. And I did my top pie crust, and y'all, this pie crust was struggling. This pie crust was struggling. Oh my God. I'm not used to making homemade pie crust. I'm, like I said, I'm not a baker. So, y'all know what it is. Then we're going to fork our crust on the edges. Just to make it look pretty, I guess. And once it's done, if you use this recipe that I'm giving you, and I will have the written recipe in the description, y'all will not be mad at it. I think I really did really good on the pie crust, considering that I'm not a baker. It tastes like a pie crust. I wish I would have put a little bit more butter on the top of the pie crust, but overall, it was pretty cool. It tasted really good. The filling was awesome. I wish I had some ice cream. Then you're going to fork the top of it so that way it doesn't bubble up. And that's how mine came out. You know how they say the most awkward looking things be the best tasting thing? This is what it is. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, and I'll check you out in the next video. Love you.